Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the words of Rav Wolbe as we are exploring deeper elements in our world of Emunah. And Rav Wolbe writes the following idea: Ha'olam she'anu chayim bo marchik ha'isanu min ha'emunah. Let's face it, he writes, the world that we are living in, by its very nature, it distances a person away from Emunah. The way we live each day, it's pulling us closer and closer to the physical world. A majority of the day, or a important part of the day, is being spent on being engaged in the choymer, in the physicality of this world. Ula. Nevertheless, with all of that, there still exists inside of a person the abilities to connect to the spiritual essence of who they are. To tilt and direct oneself in the direction of Emunah. Where do we see this? Three times a day, we are mitzapa, we wait, and we hope for the ability to make this change. Elohim zmani atfila, the three times a day we're referring to shachris mincha marav when we pray. Behem misroime ma'odam la'olam gavoya yoiser. During our prayers, a person goes way up to a much higher place. U'mis'ale mikoma she'over la b'meshach hayoyim. And they go above and beyond all of the things that happen to them during the day. When a person is davening, they're praying, they're turning towards the Creator of the world. And through that, he begins to live once again with his emunah, with his face, with his faith. And he's teifes, he grabs onto his world, he kind of finally gets it under control, and it's mishtanis, it can change. The whole day can be going along, things can be difficult, struggles, challenges, whatever happens in a person's life, and he's completely consumed in this physical world and the reality that is around him. However, he stops in the middle of his day, and he stands up before Hashem, and he prays, and he pours out his heart, and he recognizes that there's a master, creator of the world. He's the one that's running everything, and through my prayers, I can elevate myself up above all of the silliness and the frivolity of my life and connect myself to Hashem. That's how a person reconnects with the gift of Emunah. And he writes that we explained previously that matzav by ha'odam korov leboiroi v'chai yoyse gavoya, that when a person is living with Emunah, they're living closer to the Ribbono Sha'olam. Chaim megushamim soisum lechaim beroivet shel Emunah. The physical life and the matters of this world, they're a direct contradiction to the way in which that a person wants to live with Emunah. Me'avak zeh. We are constantly trapped in between these two worlds. However, when it comes time to pray, we're able to go up above the physical world. We begin to feel that it's much easier for a person to pray. And he concludes this section with the following. Unfortunately, we all know we're not always privileged to connect ourselves to our prayers. Many times we're consumed with the thoughts of jealousy, of desire, of chasing after our honor. And when a person's mind is enraptured in those lowly things, it chases after us and it removes us from focus and paying attention to the things that are important, like seeing the Ribbono Sha'olam in your life. כשנצליח לחיל בנו מהפכה, זו ללחיוס ברמה רוחניס יויסה גבויה, but when we will be successful to carve out inside of ourselves this mapecha, this difference that we're uprising, that we're making this revolution with inside of ourselves to live in a higher level of spirituality, then it's easy, or we're able to connect to the master of the world, and to live in the world of Emunah. Wishing everybody a wonderful day that is filled with an olam ha'emunah, a world in which you live, you breathe, and you partake of the emunah that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gives to us. Have a wonderful day.